हम गोइंग टू लर्न अ सोशल साइंस इन दैट अवर टॉपिक दैट इज डिससैटिस्फैक्शन अमंग द पीपल. ओपन योर बुक एवरीवन, पेज नंबर 22. Dissatisfaction of people, that is the topic. Now pay attention everyone. After the policy of subsidiary alliance, their house's policy of annexion shook the whole nation terrible. This resulted in the dissatisfaction among the people towards the British. Here, what happened? Here, after the policy of subsidiary alliance, Dalhousie introduced the subsidiary alliance system. After that, Dalhousie's policy, that is annexion, it means to take over their nation, shook the whole nation terrible. This resulted in the dissatisfaction among the people towards the British. Dissatisfaction among people towards the British. You must have seen the film, that is Kranti and Mangal Pandey. Which? Kranti and Mangal Pandey. This is the two main movie. In that, the dissatisfaction of the people or the British rule is given in these two film. If you have not seen, then try and see these movies. At this time, the people were suppressed under the dictatorial reign of the British. In addition to that, the reforms made by Dalhousie added fuel to fire. Yo. Now the Dalhousie made a reform, that is fuel to fire. Different people reacted differently to railways, facilities of post and telegraph and western education. Different people reacted differently among the railways facility to post, then telegraph facility, and then western education. Orthodox people felt that the British wanted to destroy their culture. The reforms done by British were basically for running the administration smoothly. The dissatisfaction of people had reached a point of saturation and they were in the state of rebellion, which resulted in the freedom movement of 1857. Where the freedom movement Why the British have come in the India? and ruler, become the ruler in the India to destroy the culture of the India. And now, basically run for the administration smoothly, the dissatisfaction of people has reached at the point of the saturation. And then were the sad revelation which resulted in the freedom movement of 1857. Now the dissatisfaction among the people are becoming more and more day by day. So now it's time to saturation, to do a fight with the opposite thing, all the dissatisfaction, all the Britishers. So here the rebellion, it means now the all have together to find their right and to do the as per their rights, not the British rights and rules. Clear? So here now the movement, that is freedom movement, was started in the year 1857. Clear this? Okay, now here we completed our chapter number 4. Now the exercise question, that I'll give you the PDF of that, and then you need to write the exercise question in your fair book. 5 question answer is there in a exercise. How many? 1 to 5 question. Exercise question, that is 1 to 5. Clear? I hope this chapter is clear to you. Now, moving further to the natural disasters. Natural disasters. Now, on 12th March 2011, Krishna saw the picture of the tsunami in the newspaper. Here, on the 12th March 2011, Krishna saw the picture of a tsunami in the newspaper. After reaching school, he asked her class teacher that, "Sir, I read the news about the tsunami in the newspaper. How does tsunami occur?" Sir replied, "Natural disaster are two types, disaster like earthquake and tsunami and the volcano occurs due to the changes in the interiors of the earth. Why these the natural disaster are happened? It is the happened or the occur due to the change in the interior of the earth. It means the under the earth there is some changes occurred. So if there is some changes occurred at the time, the natural disaster will take place. Whereas disasters like flood, cyclone, forest, fires, drought, etc. occur due to the changes of the surface of the earth." Here, what given? Given that whereas the disaster like flood, cyclone, forest fire, drought, etc. occur due to the changes of the surface of the earth. Now moving further to the first disaster, that is earthquake. Now, what is the meaning of earthquake? The weak upper crust of earth suddenly experiences tremors either due to the collisional of plate or due to the tremendous pressure in the interior of the earth. Why the earthquake moves happen? The earthquake or the upper crust of the surface of the earth that suddenly experience the tremors either due to collision of lattice or due to the tremendous pressure in the interior of the earth. If there is a pressure in the interior of the earth, then what happened? Then there is a earthquake happened. Why the earthquake happened? Pressure interior increase the pressure interior that is spread. That is spread outwards from the epicenter. If you remember that, there is one epicenter. At that point or at that area, there is more waves of the earthquake. So, in the near area, there is also earthquake, but the waves are reducing. Clear? To point on the surface of the earth, exactly above the hypocenter, focus is known as epicenter. So here, what is the given? The point on the surface, underline this, the point on the surface of the earth exactly above the hypocenter, then it is known as the epicenter. Clear? Underline this. This is important question. Epicenter. Write the meaning of epicenter. What do you mean by epicenter? So, in one mark question, you need to write that is the point on the surface of the earth exactly above to the hypocenter. Exactly above to the hypocenter, and that is the known as epicenter. Exactly above to the hypocenter, and it is known as epicenter. Clear? Now moving further, the intensity of the earthquake decreases as we. The intensity of earthquake is felt maximum around the epicenter. The intensity of the earthquake decreases as we move away from the epicenter. So here word given. The intensity, it means the waves of the earthquake that is decreases as we move away from the epicenter. This is the earthquake is for the some time, right? Or we can say that the fraction of second. Where fraction of second the earthquake was happened. So at that time also that the waves are going far from the epicenter, then that area now, that area do not felt the earthquake. We can measure the intensity of the earthquake and not its point origin hypocenter with the help of a seismograph. From where we know and how we measure the earthquakes, that much waves are there in an earthquake, how we know? We know with the help of seismograph. There are three main reasons for occurrence of an earthquake. Three reasons. Volcanic eruption. Then second reason, that is aspect caused by strict strike slip. Then earthquake caused by the subduction in active subduction zone. Why the earthquake happened? Give the three reasons. Main reason, the occurrence of earthquake, that is earthquake caused by the volcanic eruption. Or we can say that the second reason, that is earthquake caused by the strike slip faults, and earthquake caused by the subduction in active subduction zone. Now, the center of the earth is approximately 6,371 kilometers from the earth's surface. The center of the earth, that is how much? 6,371 kilometers far from the surface of the earth. It means the below, under the earth, or we can say that the in the earth, near the surface of the earth. Then the center of the earth, that is 6,371 kilometers from the earth's surface. So when we stand in the ground, from that 6,371 kilometer under the earth's center of the earth. Clear? Where the center of the earth? The duration between the earth's surface and center of the earth, that is 6,371 kilometer. Clear this? Now what we learn in earthquake? First, the meaning of the earthquake, why the earthquake that happens, and then we learn the epicenter, right, and hypocenter, and the measurement of the earthquake, that is seismograph. Clear this or not? Why we focus to the epicenter and hypocenter? From that we know the value of the earthquake. Clear this? Now here the earthquake meaning, that is valves or the tremors of earthquake origin from its hypocenter, which is deep down below the surface of the earth, and such sudden shaking or trembling is known as a earthquake. Clear this? And the point on the surface of the earth exactly above the hypocenter is known as a epicenter. What is the non-epicenter? The epicenter means the point on the surface of the earth exactly below or exactly deep down, exactly above to the hypocenter, that is known as epicenter. Clear this? Now you need to do homework, that is homework in a rough book, and three reasons why the earthquake will happen. There are three reasons is given. So first reason, that is volcanic eruption, that we will learn further, clear? Then earthquake caused by the strike slip force, and then subduction in an active subduction zone. Now in a homework you need to write the question, that is not on earthquake. Not on earthquake, one time you need to write, and from the page number 23 on your textbook, from the textbook you need to write the whole point, that is earthquake. Clear? And if you have any query regarding the earthquake or the chapter number 4, then you can ask me in a group. So if you have any query or any line you didn't understand, then you can ask me, and next lecture I will solve your query. If you have any query, then in the next lecture I will solve it. Clear this? In the next lecture, or you can see in the picture the disturbance of the earthquake that is given and the sins of destruction due to the earthquake. See in your book, everyone. There is an epicenter is given, then hypocenter is given. See in the pictures. In the earth, there is plates. Plates means the rocks. Not small rocks, but bigger rocks. Or we can say that the plates of the rocks. And there is a disturbance. Why there is a disturbance in the earth? This is all because of the atmosphere. Now, in the next lecture, we discuss the volcano. Clear? In the next lecture, we will see that is volcano. Okay, students. Do your homework and bye and take care.